Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the first episode on marathon training. The marathon is a very fascinating and popular sport pursued by many recreational, semi-professional as well as professional runners all over the world. And it is rightly said that if you run a marathon at least once in your lifetime, it will completely change you and make you a better human being in all walks of life. In this new series, we will be covering all the aspects related to the science of marathon training, diet, carbo loading, the various phases to bring the body in a peak condition on race day, how to overcome the marathon wall, speed workouts for marathon, and all other relevant topics. If the training for the marathon is done in the right way, you will be able to finish your marathon smoothly by running in the zone. The zone is a scientific sports term, which means experiencing the feeling of smoothness and running effortlessly in a race due to undergoing perfect marathon training. If you train correctly, you will also not hit the dreaded wall, which is experienced by most runners in a marathon. The marathon wall occurs mostly after 30 kilometers, where you will feel completely fatigued and unable to run due to depletion of glycogen stores and due to incorrect training. I had the opportunity to train under a NIS qualified coach for 2 years, and I have experienced what it means to run in the zone when I ran my personal best timing of 2 hours and 35 minutes. Through this new series, I will share with you all the training methods that I learned in the coaching camp. It will take up to 5 to 6 months of total training in the run-up to the marathon race. We will divide the phases of marathon training into 4 phases, that is the conditioning phase, the base or foundation phase, the speed or peak phase, and the tapering phase. In this first episode, we will be covering the first phase of marathon training, that is the conditioning phase. Before starting, it is very important to address an important issue of the right age and time to start training for a marathon. If we take a look at the career graph of most world-class marathon runners like Kenenisa Bekele, Eliud Kipchoge, Haile Gebrselassie, etc., it is evident that all these runners competed in the track events like 1500 meters, 5 km and 10 km for more than 8 to 10 years before switching on to the longer distance of marathon. Most professional runners start training for the marathon after the age of 26 to 30 years after acquiring speed on the track, which gives them advantage over other marathon runners. Even Indian Olympians Nitendra Rawat, Khetaram and Gopiti were all experienced track runners before switching to the marathon. There are a few exceptions though, where runners have been specializing in the marathon from a very young age. Even if we take a look at the top 10 performances of the recent Tokyo Olympic marathon, 8 out of the top 10 runners are above the age of 30 years. Eliud Kipchoge was 35 years when he became the first person in the world to run a marathon under 2 hours. Kenenisa Bekele is 39 years old and still competing and won the 3rd position in this year's Berlin Marathon. The peak performance in marathon usually starts after the age of 30 years. In women's marathon, 8 out of the top 10 Tokyo Olympic marathon runners are under 30 years of age. But the 9th and 10th position finishers are 41 and 44 years respectively, which proves that even women can compete at global stage at an older age. There are various reasons for peak performance in marathon at an older age compared to other sports. 3 of the main reasons for this phenomenon are maturation in the musculoskeletal system, improvement in running economy, and the mature psychology and mindset towards marathon training and racing compared to much younger athletes. Now let's talk about what is the prerequisite to start training for a marathon for recreational and other semi-professional runners. The answer depends on two factors, that is the fitness level of the athlete and the number of years of training put in by the athlete. To get a rough idea, it would be prudent to start training for the marathon only after you have undergone at least 2 years of regular long distance running training and have completed the half marathon distance at least a few times. This is very important because the marathon distance demands respect in the form of regular training and high levels of fitness. Most recreational runners start training for the marathon from the very first year, which is not right, since the marathon takes a huge toll on the body and can result in injury due to overtraining and sudden increase in the training load. This also leads to stagnation in performance and incomplete long-term athlete development. So now let's start with the first phase of marathon training, that is the conditioning phase. The conditioning phase is for 4 to 6 weeks and focuses on building the fitness levels of the athlete so that he becomes ready to handle the high weekly mileage of the base period. The focus should be on building functional strength and core strength with 2-3 sessions of gym workouts every week. Core strengthening can be done 4 days in a week during the evening sessions after warm-up running. For more details, you can watch my video on strength training for long distance runners. The weekly mileage is not high compared to the foundation or base period. In the first week, we can start with 50 km per week, second week 60 km, 70 km and 80 km in the fourth week. You can increase or decrease the weekly mileage as per your fitness levels. It is important to avoid very high intensity speed workouts and we should focus on running at a slow and medium pace. Instead of focusing on the number of kilometers, we should focus on the total time. For example, 30 minutes slow running instead of 6 kilometers. In the conditioning phase, we will not yet start with the marathon specific long runs like 30 to 35 kilometers. In the conditioning phase, we will restrict the 2 weekly long runs for 60 to 90 minutes. Patience is an important factor during the conditioning phase. You may have the urges to do faster and longer workouts during the conditioning phase, but doing so will have two detrimental consequences to your long-term progress. First, it will result in an early burnout and you won't be able to handle the volume and intensity of the upcoming phases of training. Second, you may attain early peak condition. It is important to remember that the body needs to be brought in peak condition during the race day and not during such an early phase of training. The detailed sample weekly program is given below for the conditioning phase and involves short runs of 30 to 40 minutes on Monday and Thursday, strengthening sessions on Tuesday and Friday, and slightly long runs on Wednesday and Saturday. Thank you for watching, and we will see you in the next episode.